Always low, low prices at Pahrump Valley Auto Plaza.
We're on the verge of not having one at all. And then Linda Cass reached out to me, who usually runs the Pahrump Film Festival, the High Desert Shorts Film Festival. And she asked me if I can be involved, if there's anything I can do. So I jumped at the opportunity.
Did the name change then?
Just for this one, we're kind of just going with the 9CC Youth Film Camp Festival.
Wonderful. So.
It was actually pretty intense because it was much more short notice than that usual year to prepare. So I was called maybe 2 or 3 months ago, mm-hmm. asking if I could help out. And I guess I didn't jump right on. But then once I jumped on, we put everything together. Yeah. We're able to get a grant from the NICC, which was awesome because we were able to get some good equipment for these kids to really see how to shoot this thing the right way. We did a few. There was a young man who's doing his own, all on his own. It's a big secret. He won't let anybody see it.
Yeah.
And then myself, I helped to run 2 youth film camps, one for Faith Fellowship, who also helped to get this all put together, and one for the NICC youth group, and one for the 4-H.
Wonderful. And so this is all going to be shown at Nike Communities Coalition, right?
Yes, that's where we're going to hold the festival. It's going to be, first we're going to do a set of all the past youth film groups and all of their films, just so we can kind of ramp up to the 4 that we're going to show for this year. Usually it's a full-on film festival that Linda Cass hosts, and she was just kind of taking some time off this year, so we just put something together at least for the youth, because the 4-H Minecraft Club had already made a film. Mm-hmm. The youth that were going to make a film needed some kind of outlet, so now they all have this kind of outlet to show those 4 films. We're actually going to have it on July 13th, mm-hmm. from 3:30 to 9 p.m. There's a $2 fee at the door. All of the proceeds are going to go towards the 4-H and I believe Faith youth group, so that way we can, you know, make it worth something for those kids. The 4-H are actually going to be holding like concessions, popcorn, and drinks as well to try and raise some money for the 4-H Club. It's definitely a family film festival. Pretty much our whole showcase is brought on by all of the past youth camps, as well as the ones this year. So.
And so, are you still taking entrance at this point?
We can. If anybody wants to showcase anything, we can. The main competition will still be amongst the youth, so that way they can have their 15 minutes of fame. If you want more information, you can contact me, contact at jgblodgett.com. That's jgblodgett.com. We are going to have a couple of awards. We want to do a People's Choice Award at least, so everyone can vote while they're there and make it fun. And then, of course, we're going to have the award that is done by the judges. The two that I put together, one, the kids kind of went one way over at Faith. They did kind of a comedy crime drama thing, which was a lot of fun and a little crazy because we were out in the heat all day because they wanted to shoot outdoors. The second one, we went with more of a drama, and it's really good. I'm like getting all misty-eyed when I'm editing it. They did a great job. I think we're just going to have door admissions. Since it was kind of put together these last few months, we didn't have time to sell tickets pre or anything like that, so they can just come on in and put down their $2 donation at the door. From 3:30 to 4:30 is our red carpet event, so everyone can come dress nice and take pictures, and hopefully all the cast and crew from all the movies are going to be there, and you can take pictures with them if you like. And then 5 o'clock is when we're going to start screening. My email was contact@jgblodgett.com. That's JGBLODGETT.